it's a real pleasure to come back here. I've bumped into quite a few people here I haven't seen for a long time, which makes it even more enjoyable. To come to a centre like this, I was actually quite gobsmacked when I walked around it. It's so friendly and warm, and I can see why this will get a lot of use, and it deserves to get a lot of use, because it is a very, very good facility.
Well, it's a magnificent centre, first of all, it has to be said. I had a walk around it this morning, very, very impressive, very warm. A lot of people don't go and see the doctor because men get embarrassed with things like bowel cancer and they won't go and get it sorted. If you get it sorted straight away, you get fit again, you get healthy. And it's the same with a lot of disease, whether it's diets, whether it's blood pressure, whether it's just general dental health. It's important that people use these facilities and look after themselves and learn a bit more about looking after themselves.
So I wish you all the very, very best. Good luck with everything, you deserve it, and I'll cut the ribbon.
And it's to provide health care and health and well-being advice to the local residents and to the people of North Lincolnshire when they happen to come into Scunthorpe. So we've got practice, GP practices here. We have an 8-to-8 centre, so that's open extended hours. There's a community dentists, community nursing, physiotherapy, and of course a very large pharmacy. We have a healthy eating kitchen, for example, where mums and dads can come and learn how to cook healthy meals for their family at economical prices. People can walk in off the street, they can be referred by their general practitioner, or they can come in and the reception desk downstairs, which is manned by the WRBS, will point them in the direction of where they need to be.
Went to great lengths, really. In order to achieve the 20% renewables, we looked at a wide range of options that would help us deliver that. So in our car park, in the local authority car park, we've drilled 24 boreholes, each 150 metres deep, to deliver a ground source heat pump. The heat that's generated from that heats the underfloor heating in the atrium and throughout the ground floor. We collect all rainwater from the roof, so our roof is designed for rainwater harvesting. That's stored in tanks and we use that to flush all WCs throughout the building. Obviously we've got a very light and airy building. It's been designed at a very shallow plan so that we can get maximum use of natural light and ventilation. In addition to that, in terms of ventilation, we have a complex BMS system, building management system, which allows us to zone air cooling in the relevant parts of the building and use natural ventilation in others. We also have wind catchers on the roof. So we've got a series of wind catchers. They actually collect and benefit from the natural movement of air, and in particular at night they draw down cold air into the building and cool the building overnight, so when we enter in the morning it's nice and fresh and cooled. We also have a series of photovoltaics on the roof, so they harness the solar energy from the sun, convert that to electricity for use within the building.
I think it's very important that people have a welcoming environment where they can go to talk about their health and well-being concerns, and that this is a welcoming environment. It says, come in and talk to me about the things that are troubling you, but it also says come in and spend some time in these nice spaces, enjoying and doing things with other people. And I know the people here are keen for this building to be used by community groups and other people for events that may be health related or not health related.
It's all about coming, bringing people here together, sharing the burden, and hopefully all walking out with a smile, whatever the cause. So it was a privilege to come down and do it.
Nicely smiled, elegant.